presentation provides an introduction to Quality Matters and how it has been implemented at UNC. First, let's take a look at the Quality Matters background. Quality Matters grew from a FIPSE grant that was mandated with finding a way to evaluate the quality of online courses. Since then, sponsored by Maryland Online, QM is now a self-supporting organization that offers institutional subscriptions and fee-based services, including Quality Matters managed course reviews and QM training. UNC subscribed to Quality Matters in 2009 to emphasize the university's dedication to offering quality online learning experiences for our students. The QM project here at UNC has had four components or facets. In 2009, Quality Matters came to UNC campus and provided some training. Since then, we've had faculty cohort groups and several online courses to teach folks more about QM. Our online program development fund provides a stipend for faculty members developing new courses and new programs that do it according to the QM model. And for the past two summers, we've had a teaching academy that helps instructors who are new to online learning about how to design and develop an online class using Quality Matters standards. These are some of the current programs that have been developed using QM standards. Our BA completion in sociology, several master's degree programs, a certificate in special ed autism, Doctor of Nursing Practice. In addition, we have several upcoming programs that are being developed using Quality Matters standards. Some master's degrees and certificates. So what are the underlying principles of Quality Matters? Quality Matters is a faculty-driven peer review process. So what does that mean? It means that in order to be a Quality Matters reviewer, you must be experienced online faculty and have taught online in the past 18 months. The process is collaborative, collegial, continuous, and centered. And it's centered around two things. First, it has an academic foundation. That means that it's based on national standards, research, best practices, and instructional design principles. It is also centered around student learning, because the bottom line is we really want to improve the student experience in their online classes. So let's take a look at the Quality Matters rubric and process. There's two parts of this. The rubric itself, which as I said is based on national standards and best practices and research, it can be used to review existing courses, but it also can be used as a model for new courses, and that's what we're doing in many cases here at UNC. But the rubric doesn't stand alone. There's a whole process behind this that really is designed to ensure the quality of the design of online courses, and I'm emphasizing that word design. So let's dig into that a little bit deeper. There are a lot of factors that can affect course quality. So the online quality pie, if you will. And course design is only one of these. Think about it. What are some of the other things that can affect the quality of an online course? Well, there's quite a few. The course delivery, which is actually what happens during the course, what the faculty does during the course. The course content. The institutional infrastructure, and that encompasses a lot of things. That's the help desk, the online library access, online tutoring access, but it's also the speed of our internal systems and network, things like that. The learning management system. We're using Blackboard, which is one of the more capable learning management systems. That can really have an effect on the student experience. The faculty readiness. How trained or ready are the faculty to teach online? And the student readiness. How ready are they to be online students and know what that means? Well, we're only looking at one piece of this in Quality Matters, the course design. And why do you think we focus on design? Well, there are several reasons. The design provides a foundation for the course. It is the plan, the blueprint, the foundation. And if you have a good design, then hopefully the course can be good. It is observable. We can go into an online course and see it. It's consistent. It's not dependent on technology. It's not dependent on the instructor. And it can be reviewed before the course is offered. And that's what we're trying to do here at UNC for many of the programs with which we work. So, the faculty member is a part of both elements, the design and the delivery. The course design is the forethought and the planning that a faculty member puts into the course. The delivery is the actual teaching of the course, the implementation of the design. It's what happens in the actual class itself. So the course design for discussions might be how you're planning to use discussions in the course, but the delivery is what you actually do when you deliver the course and the instructions, what you say to the students, how often you respond, etc. Quality Matters is about the design element. It's not about the delivery or faculty performance. So let's look at this rubric and process. The rubric itself is the center of everything. The rubric has 8 categories and 41 standards, and we'll take a look at those in just a minute. The process is designed to be a cyclical process where basically we take a course using the rubric, we evaluate the course, so we do a peer course review, and provide feedback. And I think this word feedback is the most important thing. It's not just about taking the rubric and saying, yes, it meets the standard or it doesn't meet the standard. It's about the feedback, why it meets the standard, why it doesn't meet the standard, and what can we do to improve it. Quality Matters says that less than 50% of courses meet the standard the first time around, so they have to go through some revisions. After the revisions, the course meets standards. And the reason it's cyclical is that QM recommends that every 3 years or so we reevaluate or take a look at the course again. But a good thing is that all courses meet Quality Matters standards at the end of the review process, as long as we go through the whole process and make revisions to the course. So, let's look at those standards. These are the 8 categories, and you can see that they flow pretty logically through what you would have in your syllabus and what would happen in an online course. Notice that the center ones, standards 2 through 6, must be in alignment. And that is a key principle of Quality Matters, that the critical course elements work together to ensure the students achieve the desired learning outcomes. So we have learning objectives, and then the assessments must measure the learning objectives, the instructional materials must support the achievement of the learning objectives, the learner interaction and engagement, and course technology support the achievement of the learning objectives, and that is alignment. So, our learning objectives are kind of the base or the foundation here. The pillars are the instructional materials, learning interaction, and the course technology. And those all help the students meet the learning objectives and assess successfully. So looking at the rubric, you'll see down the left-hand side, there are the different standards or the different categories, course overview, learning objectives, etc. The standards themselves are in the middle. And along the right-hand side, there are points. Now, these points are important because the 3-point standards are considered essential. A course must meet those standards in order to meet Quality Matters. So there are 41 standards. 21 are essential or must-have. And the 12 are very important. 8 are important. The reviewer decides if the course meets each standard or not to the 85% level. Basically, this is just designed so that we don't get into thinking that everything must be absolutely perfect. You know, things can be really good and have still a small improvement and meet Quality Matters standards. But what's important to think about is that a course must meet all standards in order to meet Quality Matters expectations, all essential standards. So let's look at that review process. There's a couple of things you need to know about that. There are 2 types of reviews. An official review, which is Quality Matters recognition or is recognized by Quality Matters, and then an informal review internal to UNC. The goal of all these course reviews is to improve the quality of the online courses. An official review, though, has specific rules. It results in Quality Matters recognition, and it requires that there are 3 reviewers, one from outside UNC, and one is a subject matter expert. Internal reviews are what we do here within UNC. They do not result in QM formal recognition, but they do result in improved quality in a course. And we can do informal reviews for any courses that you might like. To meet expectations, there are two thresholds. A course must be met on all 21 of the 3-point essential standards, and it must meet a minimum of 81 out of 95 points. So that's why that point system comes in, the reason why there's 3, 2, and 1 points assigned. So how can QM help you? Well, Quality Matters does provide us with guidelines or maybe even a little checklist about what should be included in an online class. It can help us establish a model, and what we find is that many folks, once they develop a course using Quality Matters, they use that course as a model for all their subsequent courses. And I like to say it keeps us honest. It sort of reminds us of the things that we should be doing and that we should really have clear communication and not assume that things are clear enough and understandable to the students. Another reason that I really like it is that it provides a vehicle for feedback. It's very easy to take the Quality Matters rubric and look at the standards and then provide feedback or suggestions for improvement on each of the standards. And so that becomes a communication tool between the instructional designers and faculty members, or reviewers and faculty members, for providing feedback. And overall, any course that's been through this process at all really has improved quality. As far as training goes, there is an introduction to Quality Matters, which basically we've given here at UNC just as a short presentation. There's this Applying the Rubric course, which we can give here at QM, and you'll see as you go along in this online course that you're going to have scenarios and course review to do. But then, if you'd like to become a peer reviewer, you must take the peer reviewer certification through Quality Matters. This course really centers on feedback, so it concentrates a lot on providing feedback to instructors to improve their courses. That course is approximately 1 week online, and you must have recent online teaching experience in order to become a peer reviewer. That ends this presentation, and I hope it has given you a good introduction to Quality Matters.